Okay, let me see. Okay, audio seems to be working. Everyone, hello. Thank you all for coming. Let's do it. This is pretty much one of the classes which will conclude the substantive portion. And by the time you all finish your homework, we will be all pretty much substantively, which means theoretically have the knowledge necessary to tackle the customs broker license exam based on the merits. This means that what we're going to do is we're going to have to be able to by the time we finish all the good stuff to start be able to do drills. So let me see. So I'm looking at the calendar right now, and the calendar. So we have 21st is the exam. Correct me if I'm wrong. So that means that, and we are in March 8th. I'm sorry, April 8th. So that means that what we have is we have Saturday, Sunday. By Sunday, you guys should be able to be done with a duty drawback, which was the last thing that I assigned. And on Monday, you should be able to start doing the drills. What we're going to do on Monday is we're going to start from. So first of all, how many days do we have? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on Tuesday, the week after next, I don't want you guys to do anything because if you push yourself hard enough, you need a day off to kind of take a breathe and put your mind together. So that means that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 days to do the drills. So ideally it would be one exam per day completed altogether. Realistically, I know it would be difficult. It is kind of ambitious. So maybe seven exams I think would suffice. So what we're going to do on Monday then is we're going to go to the compilations, count down seven exams, and starting from the latest. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3 doesn't count because of COVID, but 3 is really 2, right? So from April 2018, all and moving up all the way to October 2020, every day will be the drill, one per exam. It's very important to complete through the whole exam, so that way you have a whole picture. This will also give you the possibility of recollection. Now, so since this is the last substantive class, and I promise not to leave you guys alone on this one, a lot of you have been coming to me with good questions. Some of the questions I had to scratch my head on and then revamp and get back. But we had good questions on evaluation. We had good questions on other stuff, classification. So what I want to do is I want to do this. So while I'm still open to all the inquiries from you guys coming back and forth, what I want to do is I want to have kind of like the open house. So on let me see. So on Tuesday, next Tuesday and next Thursday, from let's say 6 until whenever, what I'll do is I'll send out the Zoom link, which and I'll be just hanging out in the Zoom room, waiting for you guys to come forward and ask me any questions. I unlike this type of streams, which I'm heavy, which I have had on a regular basis. What I'll be doing is, I will not come with any agenda. I will ask you guys to be proactive if you want to. If you guys are too busy or whatever, then I'll just go home. Tuesday and Thursday, next Tuesday, next Thursday, I'll be sending out the invitations. And I will not have any preparations or anything. I'll just come in empty-handed and expect to have you guys throw questions at me instead of me being proactive, kind of like right now, and talking about things as I have been throughout this class. So that's what we're going to do for the next week. So expect that. That doesn't mean that you are not welcome to ask me any questions in the meantime. The thing is, as you probably have noticed, when sometimes as you go through the practice, sufficient amount of questions comes up. So separate email communication is not that efficient way of taking care of it. Sometimes I'm not around to answer until next day, or if it's a weekend, maybe next week. So the memory may fade, and then you have to have a go through the process of recall. So basically, that's another way of you, if you guys have issues or whatever. Just jump on the Zoom room and we'll talk about it. It will not be recorded. It will not be anything formal, structural. It will be just that. The reason I like Zoom is because of the screen sharing function. And it's more simple. I haven't been using Zoom at all previously. Well, I have been using Zoom with some of you when we chat, right? But I haven't been using Zoom because streaming, for example, me switching from this camera, switching to this camera when I need to draw on a board, going to the switching to the screen sharing mode, switching to the TV mode. All this stuff are not possible to do in Zoom. So and plus they have a limit on the bandwidth, so the quality can be kind of bad. I think it's 720 last time I checked, not 1080. Although they may have raised the limit recently about the stream bandwidth and therefore the quality of the stuff. If I draw something, you may not be able to see it. So that's the reason why I go back and forth using different software. All right. So with that said, let's go to the next item. So what we wanted to focus on today is something which is a relatively new creature. It's called the business rules, and this is something which is a new kid on the block. Before it doesn't mean it's something which is really new stuff. No, it is not. Previously, customs had a system called Automated Commercial System, or ACS. That system was used, well, pretty much it was just a different bunch of codes and a bunch of communication tools between what customs calls trade, or in other words, international trade community, and the government itself. And they decided to use to implement something, a different system is now called ACE. So it's all just a metaphor for the big IT stuff. And but this stuff, the ACE specifically, has been started to appear on customs license broker exam since October 2018. They started out slow, so they started out like with one question per exam. They have been expanded this to two or three questions, fortunately for us, and the reason I'm saying fortunately is because this ACE business rule stuff, this is highly technical stuff. So it's the stuff we already talked about. I had you go over throughout the books, chapters. For example, anti-dumping. What is the meaning of normal value? We talk through that. The business rules by themselves, they don't ask you about the role of ITC, or role of International Trade Commission, or the role of Department of Commerce, and various types of reviews, like sunset reviews, for example, because that's more substantive, right? These guys are more like, okay, which button do I need to press, or what kind of procedure do I need to follow through to achieve the result I want? Because the system's language is calibrated to accept certain functions and not to accept the other functions. So it's in a way, it's kind of more boring, kind of more technical than the rest of the stuff. But at the same time, this is a must know. So that's the bad news. The good news is, customs examiners have been very good about sticking to certain provisions, but not all provisions. So basically, customs examiners announced that anything from chapters, from section 1 through section 12 is a fair game. So out of how many pages? 126 pages? Yeah, so out of 126 pages, you will be responsible for the first 24. Realistically, however, customs, if you're looking at the history, customs have tested on section 2.0, customs have tested on section 3.0, customs have tested on section 5.0, which deals with blanket declarations. And this is familiar with us because we covered it in a way when we looked at anti-dumping in part. Post-summary correction, 7, and reconciliation, which is section 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So out of 12 sections or chapters, they only historically have asked 5 of them. It doesn't mean that they are not going to ask on others, but it does mean, however, based on the precedent, which has been developing, as I mentioned, since October 2018, customs are very much likely to ask on the same stuff as they asked before. In fact, you see a lot of questions repeat themselves from exam to the exam, especially on stuff which deals, for example, with I think manual entry and reconciliation, post entry as well, post summary correction as well. So those guys are have been consistently appearing. So if we cover, the goal is to look at those not to look at all of them, but to look at all those five to kind of have a laser vision and laser focus, I'm sorry, to and focus on the style which have been covered by custom examiners in the past. So that way we really manage our time efficiently and in a good position to answer the stuff that are likely to arise on the exam.